I was working in a bank and I was lending people money to go do their dream. And they would be so happy and leave, and I was still there with a coat and tie on. I got to see these people running off into life where I should have been running. I truly believe that you regret the things you don't do more than the things you do. I've been extremely fortunate to have been able to travel to destinations that I never dreamed. Fishing for giant trevally in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, Midway Island. And it was all because of taking that leap of faith and taking off the coat and tie and going for it. When I left the corporate world, the freest thing on the horizon for me was guiding. You got up every day and you got into a skiff with people and you were with them at the very, very happiest moments of their year. You could see them decompress the first day, but you got those rare moments with them. There is an alchemy that happens in a small skiff, a bond that transcends friendship. Things get said in a skiff that wouldn't get said in a confessional. I think that there's a direct correlation between how much you value your leisure time and what you're willing to spend to make those moments more productive and more enjoyable. For the average guy, I mean, he steps down into his skiff, puts his hand against the piling and pushes away. The instant his hand leaves that piling, he's really leaving his cell phone, his responsibilities on the dock. If he picks up any tool in his skiff that's not excellent, it diminishes that moment. One of the most precious, irreplaceable moments that he'll ever have. I mean, you can't replace the time. You simply can't. You can't buy it back. You can't earn it back. It's gone. And a young man may not appreciate that as much as an older guy does. But trust me when I tell you that, in retrospect, there's nothing more valuable than those moments.